Hello, my name is Beth Vernig, and I am the PI of the Research Data Assistance Center and a professor at the University of Minnesota School of Public Health. Today I'm going to be talking to you about defining a research question for applications of CMS data. So as a first step, I think it's important to clarify why this is an important process. And the reason is for CMS data users is that HIPAA allows for healthcare-related data to be released for research purposes. So therefore, it's essential that all users of CMS data need to be able to write their request in the form of a research question. So it isn't about importance, but it's about whether it meets this criterion. And if, in fact, you were to write your question not in a research format, your request would be denied, not because it isn't valuable, not because it might not be useful, but in fact because it hasn't met the criteria for release of the records. So research is about the creation of generalizable knowledge that has value beyond describing the specific subjects and circumstances. So that is to say that in addition to the knowledge I might get about the 42 people in my study, that knowledge will have value beyond those 42 people. So oftentimes research is about asking questions in the form of how variables relate to each other, associations, and answer questions about the role of, association with. Now notice, it doesn't have to say causes. So it doesn't have to go all the way to causal, but it really is asking how different things relate to each other. So research is not about describing the state of the world at a particular point in time. Asking what was happening in 2012 is not a research question. You may end up describing what was happening in 2012 in the process of answering your research question, but research is about something that extends beyond that. And developing tools that are not linked to research questions is not research. You can develop tools, but for them to count as research, they need to be linked to a research question. So now let's go through some examples to see if this helps. Consider the following. I want to know whether the patients who came to my diabetes clinic on Thursday got guideline compliant care. This can be a very important question, particularly for people who are interested in having their clinic work as effectively as possible. However, it is not a research question. It's far too specific. The patients, my clinic, on Thursday. It's far too precise. So while it might be locally important, it's not generalizable knowledge. However, if we rewrite it to say, I want to know what predicts receipt of guideline compliant care for diabetics attending family medicine clinics. Notice this is broader, and it's a research question. It's asking about a broader group of patients. It still is specific to clinics, but it's really asking about predictors. It's asking about broader associations among variables. Another example, consider the following. I want to develop an algorithm to classify admissions as complicated or not. This is really important for people wanting to use Medicare data. There is no field that says this is a complicated admission. We need to create our classification system, and that is not a trivial process to do. We've all spent many, many hours trying to do it. However, as written, it's not a research question. There's no purpose for the tool. It's just a method to do it. I just want to do it. Why do you want to do it? I just want to do it. However, if we rewrite it a little bit, we can turn this into a research question. I want to develop an algorithm to classify admissions as complicated or not, and then use it to identify predictors of complicated admissions. So it's about the application of the method that turns it into research. We still are developing the same tool, but now we're applying the method for generalizable knowledge. Finally, consider the following. I want to create a book of maps to show how use of procedures varies across geography. Again, chart books, we do this frequently. They can be very useful, and we often get considerable insights from them. But the chart book itself, the map book, is not a research question. We're just creating pictures describing things at a point in time. There is no theory, there are no associations, and there's no stated goal of generalizable knowledge beyond what is being shown in those maps. However, again, we can rewrite this just slightly and it changes completely. I want to see whether variation in procedures vary geographically by, and I can list things, local area income, number of hospital beds, urban-rural status. I'd also like to map use. Notice I'm still mapping use. I'm still creating my book of maps, but I'm also asking questions about predictors of geographic variation. So, bottom line, for something to qualify as research, the knowledge must extend beyond the specific being studied, patients, admissions, records, providers. Next, there must be some hypothesized association among things being measured. You don't have to be right, but you have to say, even very generally, I think this is going to vary by urban-rural status. I think this is going to vary by age. I think this is going to vary by gender or race or comorbidity status. We have some idea that something is going on that we want to test. And while tool development is allowed, it has to be secondary to the plan to use the tools for answering a research question. So don't forget, when we propose our studies, they can have multiple goals. It's okay for one goal to be the development of a method or the creation of maps or graphs, as long as one goal in your proposal is generalizable knowledge. And whether creating a tool or conducting an analysis, the use, inference, and knowledge must extend beyond the specific exact records being studied. And if you keep this in mind, you should have no trouble writing a research question and getting your study approved. Thank you very much.